continuing the tradition.
Here he goes. See you later. And he's got it on the record. Touchdown! Touchdown!
ABC Sports Championship Television.
Colorado's the two-time defending champion of the Big 12 North. Today they're challenged by injury, the heat, their first trip to the East Coast in 26 years, and a Florida State team that's unbeaten, back in the top 10, and looking again like the cream of the ACC crop. Look at these two teams at midfield. Seminoles set to judge the Buffaloes' tough hide and their own murderous non-conference schedule. So they're holding court in New York to determine the nation's top team.
Country. Less than a month into the season, a handful of teams are making a case that they are number one. Exhibit A features the Oklahoma Sooners, whose explosive offense has matched their world-class defense. Today, the UCLA Bruins try to punch a hole in their argument. For Exhibit B, we present the body of evidence that the Michigan Wolverines have displayed, featuring the nation's leading rusher, Chris Perry. However, the Oregon Ducks are ready to take the stand against the maize and blue. Exhibit C, the Florida State Seminoles, a team that never needs an alibi because their defense allows a mere 5 points per game. The verdict is still out on today's opponent, the Colorado Buffaloes. So who is the real number one? We'll let you, the members of the jury, decide next on ABC Sports.
College football Saturday here on ABC, and welcome to Times Square Stadium here in New York City. John Saunders and Terry Bowden as usual, but we are joined for the rest of the season and beyond by Craig James from ESPN for a player to be named later. We're going to put you on the spot right away. Who do you like for the national
championship? And I'm glad you're going to let me stay the whole year. You know, let's do that. Now, my pick here, y'all are going to pop at me, I'm sure, but Oklahoma, we all like them, and I like USC to play in it. Today, the Pac-10 needs to prevail over the Big Ten. These are big games because of the strength of schedule down the road, but I like USC.
I got one question. How can USC be the national champion when they can't be the Pac-10 champion? The last 5 years, the Pac-10 has had a senior quarterback for the last 5 years.
I'm just going to worry about today.
Okay.
I'm going to pick one from each of you. I like USC to face Michigan in the national championship, the Nokia Sugar Bowl. We, of course, will be here at halftime all day long with scores and highlights, but be sure and get back to us at halftime, something you will not want to miss. Out to your games after this.
A few of us had actually never built a set before, so there was a learning curve involved.
When working in television, lighting is important. Now, the best sets are your basic Western frame with open sight lines.
Yes. So the audience can see us, and we can see the camera.
Exactly.
Can I use a jackhammer?
There were times when it looked like everybody might not be on the same page.
Starting with me, everything in this place is mean and miserable.
Is that a tear in your eye, Private? Do you want your mommy? Are you going to cry?
I'll kick the tradition and chivalry out of you.
I suggest you shut your mouth.
I can't hear you.
Nothing is over until we decide it is.
Just one more thing. Don't ever make me mad.
Sweet dreams, ladies.
Pray to live, right now. Ha!
Saturday.
Undefeated, ninth ranked, Florida State. Sold out Doak Campbell Stadium. On a hot September day, the number 9 team in the country in a Big 12 battle against the Buffaloes of Colorado here in Tallahassee. Welcome, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler with Bob Greasy. It is a hot one. I don't know if Colorado's ready for the humidity. Maybe by training at altitude, they'll be ready for it. I don't know, but Gary Barnett brings in a team that's 2-1, coming off a disappointing loss. But he kind of likes these situations against a team that's favored.
Well, he's coming in. He's without his starting quarterback and his starting running back and his best defensive player, but he kind of likes this us-against-the-world mentality. Go back to the mid-90s at Northwestern of the Big Ten when he won back-to-back titles. And the last 2 years in the Big 12, he's been in the conference championship game. Gary Barnett likes this environment.
Well, his team, I guess, if they come to the East Coast for the first time in 25, 26 years, they're on a mission. This time last year, this guy was on one.
A two-year Mormon mission. He just got back this year, was a third-string quarterback, and now because of injury, he is the starting quarterback, making his first start today. His chore is to get the ball to the big play guys, the wide receivers and the tight ends. They've got some skill players if Eric can get them the ball.
The defense of Florida State right now looks like the teams we remember from the 90s. It's the offense everybody's worried about.
Yeah, the defense is playing well. It's the offense that's coming back, and the guy is Chris Ricks. He's in his fourth year. He's a 25th year, 25 starts now for the last two drives last week. Won the ball game. This could give him a big bonus. And going up against this defense today, there are some big plays out there to be made. Look for him to have a big day.
That's what he's hoping for. Look to our third man on our team to have a hot day. Let's go down in the field and Lynn Swann. Swanee.
Well, it will be hot down here, but offense is what they always talk about. But coach, defense win champions. Can this defense be as good as your championship teams in the past?
If they keep improving every Saturday, they've got a chance, Lynn. In several years, we've played pretty good defense.
Defensive tackle Darnell Dockett, Eric Moore, defensive end. How good do they have to play to win this ball game today?
I think to have a great defense, you've got to have somebody that can make big plays. Both of those boys are capable of doing it. We got some others, but it's no doubt somebody has got to step up, you know, to make the big play.
Coach, thank you very much. And guys, just for your information on offense, Bobby Meeks, the young man who has had problems with asthma, will be starting today.
All right, we'll keep an eye on him, Swanee, and the heat will be a factor for both teams, obviously. Gary Barnett is in his fifth year, 31-22. As Bob said, back-to-back Big 12 North championships. That's his overall record in 11 seasons. Bobby Bowden, the second winningest coach ever. It's 88. It's probably going to be 90 before it's over.
It's no flurries and 37 degrees in Boulder on Thursday.
Matias with a kickoff, and Colorado won't have a chance at this one. Jeremy Bloom has to watch it go over his head. So the Buffaloes will work from their own 20-yard line with a quarterback making his first start. Gary Barnett talked about it.
He's got to keep us out of negative yardage situations and prevent turnovers from his end of it. He's got to keep our team calm and run the show. And he's going to have to do that. You know, I think it's critical the first 20 minutes of this game that Eric and really the rest of our team settles in and doesn't give up big plays in that first 20 minutes. We'll be okay after that.
Let's see if they're okay in the first snap. They keep it on the ground, and that's the way to start the ball game. That'll give your quarterback some confidence as Calhoun rips off almost 8 yards. Colorado coming in from Boulder. There's Greenberg, the guy that Bob talked about, making his first start ever. Those are his numbers from last week when he came in for an injured Joel Klatt. Threw two interceptions, did throw three touchdown passes, however.
He was in for nine drives. Three touchdown passes, but he had two fumbles and two interceptions, and that's the thing that Barnett was alerting to. Don't turn it over.
Second and short, play action and a bootleg. Wanted to throw his first pass, double clutches, and now tries to head for the stick himself. And he doesn't get there. He lost about a yard as we check in with John of the Gang in New York.
Well, Brad, it's the Mid-American Conference making some noise this afternoon. Bowling Green against Ohio State. Jock Harris back to pass trying to even this game up. He's picked off by Will Allen, and Ohio State survives yet another scare as they run out the clock and win it 24-17. Kansas State, though, not as fortunate. Down to Marshall, 27-20, with a minute and a half left to go. We'll let you know when this one is done.
We'll keep you posted on the thundering herd. Here it's a thundering crowd. Third down and three for its defense. Greenberg, quick slant, first down throw to Derek McCoy. There's one of the big play wide receivers that Bob talked about as we take a look at our Outback Steakhouse starting lineups. And this offensive line has been shuffled a little bit for this game. Wilder, Daniels, Page moves over to center, Stemmerich and O'Neill. The wideouts and running backs, Brian Calhoun starts for the injured Bobby Purifoy today. Vickers will see him in a one-back set at times. Kloppenstein's a great tight end. Hackett and McCoy are the wideouts. We've already seen Derek McCoy catch one.
There's two wideouts, and Kloppenstein, the tight end, are all big targets. The two wide receivers over 6'3", Kloppenstein 6'5".
Two tight ends in there right now. Straight ahead they go. Calhoun busts it outside. He's got open field. Calhoun across the 40, down the sideline. Going to be dragged down, but not before he gets to the 16-yard line. Brian Calhoun rips one off for 69 yards.
Take a look from behind the defense. The steady, straight blocking up inside. Calhoun breaks a tackle at the line of scrimmage. Bobby Purifoy, the starting running back, not playing today. Calhoun steps up, makes a big play right off the bat for the Buffalo.
All the way to the 16-yard line, 49-yard pickup and a first and 10. So Colorado with the chance, the tomahawk chop going in the background for the Seminoles, have it down in the red zone. Empty backfield now. And Greenberg throws, completes it inside the 10, out of bounds. It's McCoy again. He got it down near the 8-yard line. Pickup of 8.
Impressed with the way Colorado starting off. The offensive coordinator, Sean Watson, just giving Greenberg some nice, easy throws. He's picked up a first down on a slant. He's got the ball to the wide receivers, and the running game has kicked in.
What a way to start on the road in a hostile environment for Gary Barnett's Buffaloes.
One touchdown scored against this Florida State defense in the first three games of this year.
That was a 47-yard touchdown run by Georgia Tech last week in a near upset. This time they wrap up. Well, nice second effort by Vickers. Vickers spins off and gets down to the 5-yard line against the defense that Bob was talking about, and it is a veteran one and a dandy. Emmanuel, Dockett, Womble, and Moore, great front four. The linebackers, especially Pope and Bull, were very rangy, but it's Augustin that's their leading tackler, the unsung one there. The secondary veterans as well, McFadden, Ward, Carter, and Stanford Samuels.
That front seven is probably as good as you're going to see anywhere in the country. Put them up against Oklahoma's front seven.
Official timeout right now at the 5-yard line with a first and goal upcoming for Colorado. Believe it's a clock problem. John Laurie's our referee, and he looks down at the scoreboard to try to get it corrected.
It's a Big 12 crew. The visiting team in these interconference games brings their conference officials with them.
Yeah, they've got it figured out. And Colorado's got it figured out on this opening drive. Started from their own 20. They've worked it to the Florida State 5. Vickers splits out as a wide receiver on the right side. The other two to the top of the screen. Now Vickers back in motion. Calhoun slips and goes down. Augustin is the guy that made sure he wasn't going any further. So second down and goal for Colorado. Florida State, Bob mentioned, one touchdown on defense allowed this season, a 47-yard P.J. Daniels touchdown run by Georgia Tech last week.
A look at Kendall Pope. We had a nice chat with him yesterday. I'll tell you, inside the 20-yard line and down here, you like to go to your tight ends, and I know the Buffalo have gone to Kloppenstein a lot down here also.
He scored three touchdowns in four passes to him in the red zone this year. He's not going to get a chance.
You can't wait that long.
Wembley comes flying in there and sacks him back at the 10-yard line. Mickey Andrews, the defensive coordinator for Florida State, literally has 12 guys on that front four. He can rotate. Wimberly's one of them.
And he does. Wembley wasn't even blocked. The back was supposed to block him. That's not good planning and scheming. The defense does a lot of, the linebackers nose up into the defensive line, and sometimes it confuses
the offensive lineman. There's a true freshman at left guard. Daniels may have been confused that time.
On third and goal, they play it safe. Calhoun trying to weave his way to the goal line, gets back to the original line of scrimmage, and that's it. Allen Augustin again, one of the first guys there to meet him, along with Jerome Carter from the secondary, and they're going to bring out the field goal unit. So it was looking very good for Colorado, but the sack made them get conservative a little bit, and they'll try a kick here of about 22 yards.
That was their 12th sack in the last three games, a little over three games, but still a good drive if they convert on the field goal.
Kevin Eberhardt trying the kick, and it's no good. He missed a 22-yarder. Last week, Mason Crosby had some trouble as the place kicker. Kevin Eberhardt gets the start, and he misses a chip shot. So they waste a long, time-consuming drive. Still, we are scoreless in Tallahassee.
Free up your night for Outback's legendary Bloomin' Onion and our center cut filet.
Hey, John, how's work?
Working as we speak.
Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
What you seeing didn't start with LL today. Take it from me. Run DMC paved the way with Jam Master J. The K-I-N-G's. Run D and Dr. Pepper, that's originality. The taste of Dr. Pepper.
Dr. Pepper.
The taste of originality. Salutes individuality.
Individual.
Gives life personality. Be you, do what you do.
Be you.
Be you, nothing better than Dr. Pepper. Run DMC and Jam Dr. Pepper.
They set up in the eye on this, the last play of the game. And here's the snap. Hand off to the tailback. Peterson tries the right side. Wow, what a hit. But he stays on his feet, and he's broken to the outside, and it's wide open. Touchdown. Give him a touchdown.
Join Trista and Ryan and American Idol's Clay Aiken for the original reality show, Miss America, tonight at 8, 7 Central on ABC.
Kevin Eberhardt's first field goal attempt in a game situation, one he'd like to forget. Hits the right upright and out.
Well, Colorado had everybody warmed up but the true freshman.
So Chris Ricks brings out the Florida State offense at the 20-yard line. Jones, tailback in the eye behind B.J. Dean. But it's Ricks off play action. Might want it all. Throws deep out. Got his man, Caponzo Thorpe. And he's across the 40 and out to the 41-yard line.
I can't tell you how good a feeling that is for a quarterback to come out and practice all week against something that you're going to look forward to throwing against. The first play from scrimmage, you come up, you say, boy, they're in that same defense
right.
We practiced for. It's single coverage on the outside. It's just pitch and catch, and quarterbacks and receivers love it.
At the 42-yard line, so a little over 21 yards on the first play, and now it'll be
no huddle.
No huddle and a shotgun look for Florida State. This is where Chris Ricks says he's the most comfortable. Back to throw. Comfort level's going away. And he gets collared, and I mean collared, and almost lost his hat. In fact, it comes off backwards. DeAndre Fluellen with a flag down. And Chris, who had his neck bent in a funny sort of way in the fourth quarter on a touchdown run last week, has a face mask and his helmet turned
automatic
with his head in it this week.
It's
Three receivers going downfield. Chris reads double coverage. Oh, geez, that is. Ooh.
Yeah, the helmet doesn't go that way.
Yeah, Flewellen got him. Sometimes you don't intend to do that. Your hand just gets caught in the face mask as you're going by.
Remember who that was? Eric Crouch. That happened too about 2 or 3 years ago. A very similar situation, and it was a picture that was famous that whole year.
Oh, yeah.
Almost losing his head inside his helmet. So with the penalty, it's first down. It's almost at the 43-yard line of Colorado. So immediately Florida State in Buffalo territory. With a first down, and Ricks comes up throwing. It's Davis out in the flat trying to put a move on a man in a corner, but Phil Jackson makes the stop. A nice open field tackle, no gain as we check in at Times Square Stadium in New York. Here's John.
Brad here with the Taco Bell update. Marshall against Kansas State, final play of the game. Jeff Schwinn back to pass to the end zone. It is tipped by one of the members of the Thundering Herd, and they, as a team, will march off with a victory 27-20. They go into Kansas State, get the win. Tennessee, it's a final now. They beat Florida at the Swamp. 24-10 is the final. Brad.
Two home teams that weren't safe today. And here Florida State is being backed up by penalty after they got the big 15-yarder on the face mask. It goes right back the other way.
Bobby Bowden said that yesterday that we're probably going to come out and go no huddle at least a lot of the early time, because that's what Chris Ricks felt comfortable with at the end of the ball game last week in winning against Georgia Tech.
So second down and 25. And he will work from the shotgun. Chris has four wide receivers, plenty of time to throw over the middle. He overshot. I guess it was Greg Jones that was intended for it. Ended up being behind Chris Davis instead. I'm not sure where he was going with that one. But he talked with us about the fact that with the defense Colorado plays, more plays like that first snap of the ball game could happen today.
Hopefully we'll get our chances one-on-one on the corners and be able to run by them or take the underneath routes. But, you know, we're just hoping we see what we've seen on film and what they've done in the past and go out there and attack.
He saw the underneath route and missed it on the last one, so it's third down and 25. Ricks from the gun, pressured, fires, complete. Inside the 40, not enough for a first down for P.K. Sand, but they picked up a big chunk of it. They picked up 22 out of third and 25. And now if you're Bobby Bowden, you're thinking, let's go.
You're not going to pick up many third and 25s, but nice job by Ricks finding the open receiver, and they're going to go for it on fourth down.
They went on 4th and 17 last week against Georgia Tech because they were afraid of getting a field goal attempt blocked. This would have been about a 54-yard field goal, so they forget that, and they'll go on 4th down, and they're 50% so far on the year in that situation.
Single coverage at the top.
4th and 3. Play action. Ricks. Home run down the middle. Got Profonzo Thorpe. Touchdown. Ricks, a strike to Profonzo Thorpe for the touchdown. Yards right on the money.
That's a way to start a ball game.
Batia in for the point after. He hasn't been automatic on point afters this year. 11 of 12. This one's right down to Ball Street. So Colorado got no points out of their long drive. Florida State comes back and throws a touchdown. The Seminoles lead the Buffaloes 7-0.
On an uncharted island, 12 fierce competitors have gathered for
the Capital One Mascot Island Challenge.
We've separated America's favorite mascots into the polyester and wool blend tribes. First event, Iron Mascot Marathon.
Cast your vote for the National Mascot of the Year at CapitalOneBowl.com. Tune in the Capital One Bowl to see who wins.
Who cares what's in a hot dog? When diverse, cast-aside elements come together to form something great, well, that's the American way. No, sir. Far better to ask yourself, what are you made of? What spice do you add to the national knockwurst? What flavor do you contribute to the high life?
Well, that's the last of it.
The original rugged Nissan Pathfinder, and coming soon, the new full-size Pathfinder Armada. Two Pathfinders, countless adventures.
ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Nissan and your Nissan dealer. SBC, ordinary people, extraordinary job. And Miller High Life, to live simply, proudly, boldly, manly. This is the High Life. That's the man there at the end, bringing up the rear of the Ducks. And the Ducks were on the pond for Colorado's defense as Chris Ricks, 4 for 5 on the Nissan scoring drive for 80 yards and a 37-yard strike to the guy sitting next to him, Crofonzo Thornton. Take a look at the touchdown, Greece.
Well, the first thing the quarterback sees is nobody in the center of the field, and you got single coverage out here. The route that he's going to run is just a little post route. Play action pass, sets up, hits him right on stride. I mean, this is what they were preparing for. This is what they're getting. Colorado is 107th in the nation in pass defense,
yep.
And that's why. They don't give any help to the guy in the center of the field.
You heard Chris Ricks say, I hope we get what we saw on film and what we practiced for. You heard Bob say single coverage, and just like that, touchdown. Jeremy Bloom now, dangerous return man, is both a punt and kick returner, is back deep. Let's see if Batia even gives him a chance at it, though. This one he will have a shot at. Nope, it's going to go to Billingsley instead, and he slips and falls as he crossed the 10-yard line. So not good field position again. Billingsley trying to make a cut, and that's going to put the Buffaloes in a bad spot, and they come in shorthanded anyway. They don't have their starting quarterback, Joel Klatt, because of that hit, among others. Marcus Harris, their best defensive player, broke his leg against UCLA. Carl Alice, one of their best linemen, out with a concussion, and Bobby Purify would be starting in the backfield. He's out with an ankle injury.
Yeah, but still in all, that first drive was a great drive. They just didn't convert the field goal.
Inside handoff going nowhere for Calhoun as he lost two. Eric Moore made sure he got nowhere, and Moore has been playing like a madman. He was all over the Georgia Tech backfield last week. He had 2.5 sacks, forced a fumble, recovered a fumble. And still Mickey Andrews said, yeah, but he was the guy out of position on the 47-yard touchdown run.
Yeah, yeah. And there's Daniels, number 66, starting at left guard, or the weak side guard. They flip-flop him.
True freshman,
yeah,
right
true
out
true freshman.
Evergreen, Colorado, right there near Boulder, and 300-pounder, but still, that's asking a lot in a place like this against a team like this. Same thing for Eric Greenberg, and he's going to have to call a timeout right here. Didn't like the look of either his set or the defense, and he'll take a timeout with 8 minutes and 39 seconds remaining in the first quarter. The Buffaloes, having driven the length of the field earlier, missing a field goal, now trying to put something together from deep in their own territory. We'll see how they do when we come back.
I'm out of town at a convention, and a bunch of us decide to go to dinner. I tell the cabbie to head for Hollywood on Lewis Street. The cabbie pulls up in front of Hollywood Dry Cleaners. Huh? Luckily, I just signed up for InPhone. Hello, InPhone. I'm looking for a restaurant called Hollywood on Lewis, but it appears I've been taken to the cleaners. The operator says, are you sure you don't want Louis on Hollywood? She connects me.
New in town? Don't just make a call. Make an InPhone call. Sign up is free at InPhone.com.
I tell my friends, you better save me some calamari.
Hey, you okay?
Yeah. Life's little expenses. Another good reason to keep your car around. That's why at 75,000 miles, switch to Valvoline's MaxLife. Its added ingredients help prevent wear on critical parts.
Hello, gorgeous girl.
At 75,000, time to switch to Max Life.
3 minutes to go in the period. Third down. The ball is at the 4-yard line.
Here's my man. Come on.
Pepsi and Lay's, official sponsors of the NFL.
Monday, Travolta, Uma, Samuel L. Jackson. What's got them talking? It's Quentin Tarantino's next big flick.
I love jerking you around.
Primetime crashes into Hollywood Monday.
Greenberg back in the Colorado huddle, and Bob, might have been the play clock that was the problem.
Well, it was. He comes right up the line of scrimmage, and you can see at the end of the field, at the other end of the field, right through the goalpost, that's the 25-second clock, and the thing just wore down on him. And sometimes it takes a little bit longer when you're a fresh quarterback in there to get the play in right and get it called right.
Now he faces second down and 12. Three wide receiver group, and penalty markers down. Jesse Wallace, I think the tight end on the right side may have been the guy that moved. So they're making the situation worse if it's against Colorado.
False start.
And it is.
5 yards.
Boy, and you start getting in this kind of mess against this Florida State defense, and you're asking for trouble.
It's like Gary said in the in his little interview, he said, you know, we cannot get in third and long and stop ourselves. That first drive they had was a wonderful drive on the road in a hostile environment. They just didn't convert it to points. Then they got a score scored against them on a long pass. Now things aren't going well for them. It's Mickey Andrews. Mickey says, keep them back there. We don't want to let them out of this.
Now they'll try to run, and Calhoun is swarmed under, and they do keep them in there. Darnell Dockett, Kendall Pope, and company are there.
Brad and Bob, as Colorado gets set for the third down play, going back to your conversation about the first drive, the biggest plays for Colorado in that first drive weren't necessarily second and third down. They were on first down. First down in this drive, that first drive, they were getting 7, 8, 9 yards of play that created second and short that gave them the advantage to call anything they wanted. On this short series, they haven't had success on any play.
And now they find themselves, because of that, with a third down and 18. And if Greenberg throws, it'll be from his own end zone. He won't. Calhoun trying to cut through, and he got by the first wave. Calhoun down the sideline, and he's got a first down. So he had a 49-yard romp earlier. He's got 23 here, and Mickey Andrews about ready to go to the huddle.
Look at Mickey. Boy, you know he isn't going to be happy about that. I mean, that was a nice call, well blocked, well executed. Calhoun makes a couple of guys miss and picks up a huge first down. Florida State would have got great field position if Colorado would have had to punt. And the guy that isn't going to be happy is the guy we showed you, and that's Mickey Andrews. He's a good friend. We've done a lot of games at Florida State, and you got to know him to really appreciate it.
I tell you what, yesterday's the first time I've seen him smile in a while, but he ain't smiling now. From the 26, fumble! Colorado got on it, but they got to Greenberg again, and it was Kevin Emanuel this time as we check in with John in New York.
Well, Brad, Oregon started out very well. Nice long drive, lining up for a 22-yard field goal. It is blocked by Darnell Hood, picked up by Jeremy Lasur, who sees nothing but daylight. 78 yards for a touchdown, a 6-0 lead as they miss the extra point attempt. Wolverines haven't had their offense on the field yet. They're up 6-0.
Nice start for Michigan. It was a nice start for Florida State. A touchdown of 80-yard drive capped by a touchdown pass. Colorado's opening march was a good one. They came up empty on a missed field goal, and now timeout again. With 6:59 remaining in the quarter.
See, Eric Greenberg has not been in a game, and things happen faster in a ball game than they do in practice, and he has not had a lot of game experience, and he's letting the 25-second clock. You got to get the play called, get him in and out of the huddle, and get to the line of scrimmage.
It got to the point where it got down to 1 second. One of his receivers was even saying, timeout, 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 trying to save the yardage. But obviously they're down to one timeout, and we still have a long ways to go just in the first half. This defense that we've talked about has already picked up 14 sacks on the season, two of them today, four interceptions. And they have the kind of depth and talent and speed that Mickey Andrews can just turn loose guys and leave his secondary out there to take care of themselves.
It's a veteran defense. Every starter and most of the backups are juniors or seniors. And that's something he's built on for the last couple of years. He's always telling us, I'm building on next year's team, right, next year's defense by playing freshmen and sophomores. Now those guys are juniors and seniors, and this is a pretty good defense.
Eric Greenberg said he talked to his dad this week. His dad said, what if you're playing against Baylor in your first start? He said, I'm kind of happy I'm playing against a great team, but obviously there are some nerves involved in that as well.
At the beginning of the week, it was pretty tough. I was pretty nervous thinking about the whole thing. Then as the week went on, I calmed down a little bit. After practicing, I felt a lot better. Now I'm a lot more excited. Trying not to think so much about the whole thing and just go out there and have fun with it.
So far, it's been Brian Calhoun that's been having fun, but he's put down after a pickup of about three.
Now, this defense is built on speed, and normally, if you got a speed defense, you run right at speed.
You run sideline to sideline,
yeah,
you're dead.
Yeah, and that's what they tried to do there. He tried to cut it all the way back, and it looked like he had a pretty good chance to come around the right side, but they caught him.
And it brings up the third and long again. Now, they got away with it last time on third and 18 because Calhoun ripped off a 23-yard run, but he comes to the sideline this time.
This is not good. You know, your third downs, the last three have been third and 10, third and 18, and third and 16.
Bloom is the third wide receiver. Over the middle they go. It's McCoy, and he's across the 30 to the 31, but he's short of the first down. Michael Boulware, the linebacker, made the stop, and Colorado's got to give it up. That just shows you the speed of Florida State's defense right there. Boulware staying with the wide receiver.
Boulware was a wide receiver at one point in time, and we always tease him about that, being a linebacker. And I asked him, did he have a little wide receiver left in him? He said, oh, yeah, I still got some.
He's got great speed for a linebacker. Torps, first punt. Dominique Robinson waiting on it, and taking it to 24. Got by the first man, not the second. And football! Colorado!
It's down.
It's been blown dead. So Robinson, only 1 yard on the punt return and almost coughed it up. Florida State will come out at the 25-yard line now as we take a look at the Outback Steakhouse starting lineup. Here's the big eaters up front: Barron, Meinrod, Castillo, Meeks, and Willis. We have to watch Castillo on a bad ankle and Meeks with the asthma problems that Swanee was talking about. Jones and Dean in the backfield. Irons the tight end. P.K. Sams and Crofonzo Thorpe. Thorpe with a couple of big catches already today. The main man, number one. Willie Reed actually into the backfield right here for Florida State on first down. They expect to use him quite a bit today. Play action for Chris Ricks. Deep out, near side, P.K. Sam. And Sam has it across the 40 to the 42. Pickup of 18. Chris Ricks is just licking his chops right now.
Oh, for sure. I mean, he's throwing against single coverage on the outside. They got an eight-man front. Just look at this. They got eight guys here. You got single coverage out here. You don't have to even run it. That's just what he's throwing against.
They haven't run it yet. And they've got a first down just inside their own 43-yard line. And now Chris changing things up. Both his wideouts in the left corner of your screen on first down. They will run it here. Willie Reed, nice opening and out to midfield. So the first time Willie touches it, he makes something happen. He's a little change of pace guy compared to Greg Jones, who does have good speed but is a huge guy. Willie's got a little more shake to him.
Well, he should have. He's 190.
Here's the Colorado defensive line. Nienhuis, Fluellen, Dabdoub, and McChesney. The linebackers, Tufts, a tough guy. Hollis in there as well. It's a 4-2-5 defense if you want to look at it that way. It doesn't always line up that way. Sorrell's in the lineup as a starter today. Billingsley, Moore, Jackson, and Joseph round out in the back five.
They thought that defense would be good coming in. They had eight starters returning, but it has not been that way.
Willie Reed, and he tries to go east-west instead of north-south. And Sammy Joseph, the left cornerback, a good one, a young fella, makes a nice open field tackle. Third down, Vince O'Crew, the defensive coordinator, Vince in his second year that they're running this particular defense.
Yeah, and Vince was telling us earlier that, one of the problems we've had is tackling. And Joseph there coming up, making a good tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
They had all kinds of trouble against Washington State last week in the tackling area. Third down and three from the midfield stripe for Florida State. And flags down. Before the Seminoles get this one off.
Prior to snap, ball start offense. 5 yards. Replay, third down.
So it's going to be third down and eight instead for Bobby Bowden Seminoles. A little mist going on the sideline. Florida State penalties, third most in the ACC. And let's see if Ricks will work from the shotgun. Right now, he's going to come up under center. From the 45, third down and eight. Off play action. Ricks dances around, now on the run, lofts one, complete. First down, Chauncey Stovall. So that time, the wheels of Chris Ricks help the cause. He finds an open receiver. It's first down, Seminole.
And the nice thing about this is Chris Ricks doesn't do this on purpose. He did this instinctively. Guys were covered. He got outside the pocket. He found Stovall. Did a little nice touch job over the defensive back. First down.
And now they're going to say Stovall was out of bounds and came back in. You might have heard John Lurie, his referee mic, just at the end caught that. And so that'll negate the first down.
Yeah, once a receiver, as he leaves the line of scrimmage, goes out of bounds, he can't be the first one to touch it.
See if we can see it. Stovall. Oh, there's the right foot. Great call.
Yeah, he touched it. And then that's what those officials should be looking for on the sideline there. Those side judge and the back judge.
Jesse Stein to punt. Just barely got it away, but it's a nice one. Hangs in the air. Bloom waiting on it. Makes a tough catch at the 16. And down he goes. Flag on the play.
Yeah. You've got to give the punt returner an opportunity to make the catch.
Not the halo anymore. You don't have to give him 6 feet, but he's got to be able to touch it.
Yeah, you can't just fly over him and intimidate him.
Catch, interference, 15 yards, spot of the foul, first down.
Well, that's going to give him great field position to be about the 31-yard line. Here's another look.
You think this guy's going to scare Bloom?
No. Hey, if he doesn't get scared by all those moguls out there skiing, he's not scared of that guy.
Yeah, I'm sure most of the people in Colorado know that Jeremy Bloom is a world-class mogul skier.
And he's a tough little customer.
Every time I see a mogul, I go the other way. Oh, boy.
So out to the 31 they come. Colorado trailing Florida State 7-0. 3:24 remaining here in the first quarter from Tallahassee. Two tight end set again. Wallace and Kloffenstein both in there. Nice play fake by Greenberg. And he finds it wide open wide receiver McCoy. And that's McCoy's third catch already. So he's becoming his favorite in a hurry. Here's today's singular wireless poll question. Which team should be ranked number one? You like Oklahoma, USC, Ohio State, Michigan, Miami?
I like that question.
Yeah. Singular users text message to 222-ABC or log on to ESPN.com. Search singular. We'll have the results of the poll in the second half of our game today.
Now, you know, this is just this point in time of the season.
Right.
You know, not before the season, not at the end of the years, because some of those teams are going to get better and some of them may get worse, maybe due to injury.
Ohio State snuck by today. Michigan out to a good start. So is Florida State's defense. Darnell Dockett. And Dockett's Nope. Darnell really playing up to his potential of what the Florida State coaching staff thought he would be 2 or 3 years ago.
Right in here in the center, watch Dockett, number 45. He just comes around the block. That's Wilder, number 74. Oh, yeah. Wilder.
Oof.
Dockett's in the backfield. Wilder, the weak side tackle, was a defensive lineman last year.
Darnell's got the Florida State record for tackles for loss, including that last one. Here's a throw out. DJ Hackett, penalty markers down. And they whistle the play dead.
Prior to snap, ball starts, offense, 5 yards, still third down.
All the penalties killing Florida, killing Colorado right now. And Florida State will take it and watch him back it up to a third down and long again.
Well, that's they're stopping themselves.
Yep.
You know, sometimes when you change quarterbacks or you go to young quarterbacks who haven't been in there a lot, the cadence is a little bit different or the timing is a little bit different.
There's Joel Klatt, who would have been the starter.
And they say that Joel's shoulder should be well enough. They're off. They have an open week next week, and they play Baylor in 2 weeks. Say that he should be back for that ball game.
They call it a third-degree sprain separation of that throwing shoulder. Here's Greenberg as replacement. He throws a strike right there for a first down.
I tell you what, these wide receivers, the three of them, Donahoe, McCoy, and Hackett, are big-time receivers.
Donahoe's the shortest of the group. McCoy and Hackett both 6'3". This time it's Donahoe on the receiving end, a pickup of 14.
Donahoe has the most speed. He's a 4'4 guy. And he's on a pretty good defensive back. McFadden was probably the top defensive back coming out of high school 3 or 4 years ago. And Mickey Andrews was telling us because of injuries, he really hasn't gotten there yet, but he's back now.
They go back to Calhoun on first down, but again, Florida State's defense will drop him for a loss. Nice play defensively by Wimbley again as we check in with John in New York.
For the BCS Spotlight game presented by ADT Update, Jason White, only one interception all year long. Here's his second. Spencer Haydner takes it and goes 72 yards. Gets the ball inside the 10-yard line, down to about the 6. And a few plays later, after being backed up, Manuel White goes in for the touchdown, 10-7.
So being at home, as I said earlier, hasn't been too comfortable for everybody today. Nice bootleg. Greenberg, and he'll keep it and pay the price. Oh boy, flag down. This will be a late hit out of bounds by AJ Nicholson.
Yeah, see, Greenberg is bringing more punishment onto himself than he needs to, but he did get a 15-yard penalty. I like the choices he's making. I like the presence of mind, the choices of not to throw the ball wildly when he gets outside the pocket and nothing is there.
Penalties, penalties, penalties on both teams. You'll see, again, Greenberg's made the decision. And now as he heads to the sideline, he's on his way out.
Yeah. See, that's tough. That's tough for a defensive guy to run all that way and then have him go out of bounds and pull yourself off. But you got to anticipate and expect that when an offensive player is near the out of bounds and he's going to run out of bounds, you got to let up.
He's been hit and knocked down and sacked, as Bob said. But he's surviving, and he's got his team a first down at the 44-yard line. Wallace, the tight end, in motion. Now they go to Vickers. Vickers, a big back with good speed, cuts outside, and he's got a first down. DJ Ward had to drag him down from the secondary, but Lawrence Vickers is a big fella at 225, but he shows he's got some speed as well.
What Colorado is doing is they're going to two tight ends a lot. Let me show you right here. There's two tight ends. One's going to come in motion across the plane, and the tight ends are going to be blocking. And right here, you got a nice little hole inside.
And Vickers took advantage of it before Ward dragged him down at about the 32-yard line as the first quarter will come to a close. Colorado had a long drive early, missed a field goal. Florida State came back with an 80-yard march and a touchdown strike by Chris Ricks. That's what we've got at the end of the first quarter. 7-0. Seminoles out in front in Tallahassee. You're watching ABC Sports Championship Television.
Opportunities are too good to pass up. The Nissan Sentra
tempers the one thing you can't get rid of by losing it.
Wasn't expecting that from a Buddhist.
Anger problem? Bring it on.
What, you think you're better than me?
It's all part of Anger Management. Now on Special Edition DVD.
The new spicy chicken burrito from Taco Bell. Packed with shredded chicken simmered in authentic Mexican spices. It's a little spicy, a lot filling, and only $1.29. To get your fill of this satisfying thrill, think outside the bun.
There was one envelope I really hated to open every month, my wireless bill. Bad news either way. I mean, if I talked too much, I got slammed with overages. And if I talked too little, I wasted all those minutes I paid for. But those days are over, thanks to Rollover.
Only Singular lets you roll over unused anytime minutes so you avoid paying overages months you talk more. They're your minutes. Keep them. Singular has rollover on national plans and your choice of cool phones.
I call it my look at that cute little bill plan.
Come in to find out how Singular fits you best.
I bought a toothbrush, some toothpaste, a flannel for my face, pajamas, a hairbrush, new shoes and a case. I said to my reflection, let's get out of this place. Tempted by the fruit of another, tempted but the truth is discovered.
Tuesday, Blues season premiere pushes the limits of drama.
The 15th precinct is a hotbed of corruption.
You'll be begging for more.
He tried to murder my boss.
And you're getting a revenge now.
Blues season premiere, ABC Tuesday. Viewer discretion advised.
I said Bob and I are going to have something to do again on Tuesday nights with Blue back.
Yes, sir.
We're back in Tallahassee. Start of the second quarter, Florida State leading by a touchdown, but Colorado has again put a nice drive together. First and 10 at the Florida State 32-yard line. Again, Wallace, the tight end in motion. Greenberg throws on the run and a sliding reception at the 29 by DJ Hackett.
You know, you come in on the road, and there's a look at Wilder. He mentioned him a little earlier. He is they call him the weak side tackle, the flop side. They flop their offensive lineman strong and weak. But he was a defensive lineman until about a week before, 10 days before the opening of training camp this summer. He had 5 sacks last year, sacking the quarterback. Now they move him over. He's an offensive tackle, and he's doing very well.
Had they known Marcus Harris was going to get hurt, though, probably he'd still be on the other side.
Exactly.
Greenberg's perfect. 6 for 6. Straight ahead they go with Vickers. And nice second effort by Vickers to get inside the 25 to the 24. And off to Times Square Stadium in New York, here's John.
The Michigan Wolverines, Brad, cannot stop the Ducks on offense. Again, Terrence White at Texas and goes 19 yards for the touchdown. Michigan had the ball 56 seconds in the first quarter, but they still trail by just 1-7-6. Brad.
That's what you call using your time of possession.
Yeah, but that's not good for Michigan
no,
defense.
Kendall Pope, who was a little dinged up coming into this game, sitting down now as Colorado has a third down and short, and the throw is incomplete, intended for Vickers on the sideline. So it's fourth down and 2. First incompletion for Eric Greenberg.
Colorado, that first quarter, had the ball 11 minutes to only 4 minutes for FSU.
They're going to give their freshman kicker another crack. Remember, he hit the right upright from 22. This will be more like 42. For Kevin Eberhardt to try to put Colorado on the board. The kick on the way. It's got the distance, but again, just to the right.
Missed them both just to the right.
So still Colorado comes away empty. Their quarterback playing pretty well. Their kickers missed a couple. They still trail number 9 Florida State by only 7.
Allstate presents Good Hands Flashback. On November 21st, 2002, the upset-minded Pittsburgh Panthers were primed to prove they could go toe-to-toe with the undefeated number-one-ranked Miami Hurricanes. This early acrobatic 5-yard touchdown grab by freshman wideout Larry Fitzgerald tied the game at 7 and sent the Panthers' confidence soaring. But it was not enough to knock off the mighty Canes, who won 28-21.
Let's say this is you. Yeah, you're the king. But being the king isn't always easy. So, when you're with Allstate, you'll have over 50,000 professionals to help protect you. From claims adjusters who can help you fix a broken castle, to emergency assistants to ride your rescue, to lawyers that go to court with you if you need them, and your Allstate agent who knows the moves to help you. Helping you, the king, feel protected. Just one more way you're in good hands with Allstate.
Hey, my customers are on the way. Where's the key? Hello? Hello, where's the key? Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Where's the key?
If your walkie-talkie service is unavailable, bad things can happen. Now there's a push to talk from Verizon Wireless, brought to you on America's best, most reliable wireless network.
Can you hear me now?
So across the street and across the country, we mean business. Verizon Wireless, we never stop working for you.
There's more to protecting your family in the summertime than knowing which sunscreen to use. You've got to make sure they're protected at home as well. And no one helps protect families better than ADT. A single ADT system can help protect your home and family from burglary, fire, and carbon monoxide. Call now and take advantage of ADT's summer special and get ADT installed at a price you can afford. You could even save up to 20% off your homeowner's insurance. ADT, always there.
The one-hour premiere your mother warned you about.
Why don't you do something about that skid mark on your chin?
I'll shave mine when you shave yours.
George Lopez, Friday at 8, 7 Central on TGIF.
Welcome back to Tallahassee. On the sideline, Kendall Pulp is surrounded by a lot of white shirts. You probably can't see right now what they're doing to him, but they're working on his left knee. He injured it in that last series, came over to the sideline. We'll try and update you as to whether or not he'll be back in the ballgame.
All right, Swally, a Butkus and All-American candidate, Kendall Pulp. Here's Chris Ricks to Chris Davis. First down, Florida State. Another strike. Pickup of 16. And it looks like Florida State will go with the no huddle.
It's not a hurry-up offense. It's just a no-huddle where you go to the line of scrimmage, you line up, see there's no hurry. The linemen are just kind of sitting around asking each other, how you doing? You have a nice time out here? All right, now let's get serious and go.
At the 40-yard line, Florida State set to get serious from the gun. Four wideouts for Ricks. Over the middle he goes, completes it. Dominique Robinson, and he might have a first down. Robinson brought down by J.J. Billingsley. Could be just a little bit short of the first down. It is. And Kendall Pulp.
That doesn't look good.
No, it doesn't. That's the pain part, he's showing.
The part that doesn't look good is him covering his face because, you know, that those of us who have played, that usually means something not too good.
Senior out of Fort White, Florida, who we spent a long time with yesterday. Nice kid, and we'll hope the best for him. Chris Ricks pumps and then tries to get the first down, and a flag comes in. You saw some of the coaches, and Chris Ricks comes up limping a little bit as he tried to tiptoe inside that marker to get the first down. Then he got shoved out of bounds.
Yeah, that happened over here on this sideline, just about where the other foul happened on Greenberg going the other way.
It was Nienhuis, the defensive end, that gave him the shove. And so that's going to be a free 15 for Florida State as we look at the end of the play.
There's Nienhuis right here.
Oh, yeah. That was a little weak.
Yeah.
He tried to pull up, it looked like.
Yeah, but he still hit him.
Yeah. Eighth penalty, four on each team already. And a first down at the 34. Ricks in the shotgun. Plenty of time to throw. Zips it to Crofonzo Thorpe. He slips and went down at about the 28-yard line. He was trying to put the brakes on and do a U-turn. And blew a tire there and went down. But coming up on the Valvoline Halftime Show, John Saunders, Terry Bodden, and Craig James will have scores and highlights from around the country. Some teams not faring too well on their home turf today. Here in Tallahassee at Doak Campbell in front of 82,000-plus, Florida State's got their hands full, really, with Colorado. But they got a good-looking drive going again. Chris Ricks is 8 of 10 passing so far today.
And on target.
Second down and four upcoming. He gets under center this time. Greg Jones is finally back in at the tailback spot. We haven't seen him since early in the quarter. They fake it to him. Rick steps up, flushed out of the pocket, trying to get to the first down, and does. Rick's wheels get him a first down again.
They had three guys out, one down the middle and two down the side. And he just took off. Gave him a chance to get open, and nothing did, and he just took off. The thing I like is he's not doing it because he wants to do it. He's doing it on reaction, on instincts. All right, if nothing's there, time's up, I got to go.
And he did for a first down to the 21-yard line. Now again with four wideouts. Throws to the end zone, got a man. P.K. Sam out of bounds. Whoa, what an effort, though. That would have been some kind of catch. He caught it. He just ran out of real estate.
His legs weren't long enough.
Yeah, that's right. Boy, that was awfully close.
P.K. is 6'3", but he's not that long. But see, this is a good throw by Ricks. He throws it to the back of the end zone where only your receiver is going to have a chance to catch it.
Oh, boy. And you hear the boos.
It was closer than I thought.
Yeah.
It still looked like he was on the little white line.
So second and 10. Ricks over the middle. What a tough catch by Dominique Robinson. And a penalty marker flies in behind. Might be a holding call as he's got somebody draped all over him and still made the catch.
They ought to call that a bear hug hold. What I saw the receiver do on that play, Bob and Brad, is something I don't see very often in college football or in pro football for that matter. The receiver is being interfered with. There's a guy draped all over him, but he still has a chance to make the catch. So many of the receivers don't continue to focus on the ball and don't make the catch when the big thing can happen. That time the receiver kept the focus on the catch, a guy draped all over him, got him by the waist, and he's still making the catch.
Yeah,
he liked that.
That was a dandy. And down to the 14-yard line it goes. So back in the red zone for Florida State. They lead 7-0, 11:20 remaining in the half. They've got it at the Buffalo's 14-yard line. Davis in motion out of the backfield. Quarterback draw by Chris Ricks. Spins down to the 5. Close to another first down. That one by design. And last week against Georgia Tech, he had one of those for a touchdown that got Florida State back in the ballgame.
They were struggling last week, and finally it was Chris Ricks's feet that got him in the end zone. This is a nice play. Three wide receivers. They put one of the backs in motion. The center and one of the backs come forward to block. They both block the same guy. And Chris picks up close to a first down inside the 5-yard line.
The second down at about a yard. Jones straight ahead. It'll be close to a first down. I don't know. Let's take you back to Chris Ricks. Last week against Georgia Tech, they were down 13-0 with about 11 minutes to go in the ball game. They got close to the goal line, and here was Chris Ricks going in from 3 yards out, taking it on the back of the neck. He had to get ice put on his neck during the break. Subsequently threw a touchdown pass to P.K. Sam, and the extra point won it for him last week, 14-13. They're going to take a timeout right here with a big third down and one with another opportunity to score. They lead already 7-0 with 10:07 remaining first half from Tallahassee.
At the count of three, you're going to be a chicken. One.
Is this dangerous?
No, you don't even need that insurance. Two.
What insurance?
If you're sick, you miss work, they pay you cash. Three, you're a chicken. Now, you're a duck.
Aflac. Ask about it at work. Aflac.
Blitz. Every chance you get. Pontiac Vibe. Fuel for the soul.
Okay, one more time. Where do we stand?
Less travel.
More video conferences.
Limit the cell phone minutes.
That's not good enough. We're not leaving this room unless we can cut something else.
Can they really keep us here?
What about all this stuff?
What stuff?
All this stuff. What does it cost to create all this? Time, effort, people.
How much?
It could be millions.
Millions.
It passes better than a West Coast offense. The newly redesigned 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix. Fuel for the soul.
10:07 remaining in the first half. Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, Lynn Swan, and our ABC crew in Tallahassee, where the Seminoles have a 7-0 lead and a 3rd-and-1. The last guy to put his hat on in that huddle was Bobby Meeks. He's the guy that battles the asthma problems and is hot as heck down here. And he's been limping around as well, so he's a little hobbled. 3rd down, 1 yard. Big play by both teams here. Colorado trying to force a field goal. Florida State might take 2 downs anyway here. Here comes a blitz. Greg Jones, left side, got the first down. 1st and goal, Florida State. Mac McChesney made the stop, but the big bull went off the left side and rumbled down to about the 1.
It's a big load there. Greg Jones, 245, 250 pounds, depending on how much he had for breakfast.
I'll tell you, I told Greg this when we talked to him the other day. The day he was born, the nurse tried to give him a bottle of milk. He said, give me meat.
He's got it down to the 1-yard line, and he's the tailback in the eye. 1st and goal, Florida State. They fake the toss to him. Ricks rolls and throws. Kerfonso Thorpe couldn't make the catch. Incomplete. Pretty good coverage by Phil Jackson. Thorpe kind of got turned around on that pass.
Yeah, that's a pass that you should hit. On 1st down, 1st and goal from the 2-yard line, you're outside the pocket. You've got all this time. Look at that. It slipped out of his hand.
Yeah, that's a...
That ball went end over end.
That's a shot putter, a discus thing. That wasn't Thorpe's problem.
No,
that one took off on Chris.
That just took off.
And guys, if he'd taken a little time just to look inside, he would have seen number 88, Donnie Carter, wide open.
Whack, 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 whack.
Last week in this situation, he ran that quarterback draw for a touchdown. This time, he'll try to follow his blockers to the end zone. Ricks, and he's put down and planted at the 4-yard line.
He's taken some shots,
he really has. Clyde Sorrell drops him for a loss of 3. And that's 3rd and goal. Sorrell back in that Colorado lineup for the first time in a long time.
Right.
Lost his little brother, who was shot outside a party and died a couple of weeks ago, so he was at the funeral last week. And I'm sure playing not with heavy pads but a heavy heart, but out there starting today for the first time all season.
For this year, he had 7 starts last year, and they're good. They're nice to, they said, nice to have you back, and they're happy to have him back.
3rd down and goal now, backed up at the 5-yard line. Inside handoff, Jones. Nope, they're not going to let him get anywhere. Nice job defensively by Dominic Brooks, a freshman who came up from the secondary and made the hit, and Bobby's on the headset.
Yeah, Bobby says that those aren't the way I'd call those plays. Bobby's not calling the plays anymore. He's letting Jeff, who's up in the booth, call them. Good series for Vince's crew.
And there's Jeff Bowden, the offensive coordinator, on the right side of your screen. So, field goal attempt after a good-looking drive for Florida State. They had a 1st and goal at the 1. They have to try to settle for a 20-yard field goal. And Batia hasn't been automatic, as you can see, so far this year. He's on the right hash. Pretty close, but he knocks it through. So Florida State tacks 3 more on with 8:19 remaining in the first half. The Seminoles leading the Buffaloes 10-0.
Happy Jack wasn't old, but he was. Lived in the sand at the island man. The kids would all sing, he would take a wrong key. So they rode on his head in their furry donkey.
Hey,
有客你堅我，好詳細我諗下聽日星期三我點辦啊
？FedEx。FedEx。
好啦，好。
FedEx Express, all you need to know when shipping to Asia.
When LA's newest cops hit the streets,
come down here.
The streets won't know what hit them.
We told them to take the stairs.
10 8 officers on duty, ABC Sunday, September 28th.
Been a long time since Colorado's been on the East Coast. Those guys have partied their way from Boulder. Their team down 10 to nothing. At the conclusion of today's game, we'll select the Chevrolet player of the game. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. There's a little Noel.
Stand up.
And Colorado will be receiving. Marcus Moore back deep. Florida State traveled 73 yards in 13 plays, but had to settle for Batia's 20-yard field goal. So Zaviet's got it teed up to kick away. Colorado, a couple of nice-looking drives today. 10 plays each and nothing to show for it. A yard deep. It's Wheatley. And he runs into traffic as he got out near the 19-yard line.
Good coverage by Florida State inside the 20-yard line.
Time now for our Aflac trivia question. And here we go. Which former Colorado Buffalo was the first man to lead the NFL in rushing in his first two seasons? There's a tough one for you. Only five have done it, we understand. We'll give you the answer a little bit later on.
Who comes up with those anyway?
I don't know.
I got an idea.
Vickers in the back of the ball. Loose, incomplete.
Nice
Eric
play.
Moore.
Nice
Boy,
play.
Eric Moore picking up where he left off last week.
Yeah. Didn't get. He got fooled initially, got back in position, and then knocked the ball down. Nice play. Eric Moore.
3.5 sacks on the season. 2.5 of those came against Georgia Tech last week.
Yeah, a fumble recovery and a forced fumble, and now he gets a pass deflected. He's going to be back in those stats with the defensive backs.
Second down at 10. And again, Colorado working inside its own 20. Greenberg, play action, lofts one, got his man. Straight skiing.
Yeah, you're right. Nobody's going to catch him. He is smaller than he looks and you think, and he is faster than you think. Good execution there. Eric Greenberg to Bloom.
Mason Crosby comes in to attempt the point after. The kick is up and good. So just like that, Jeremy Bloom on this play for 81 yards.
Here he is up here. He's just going to go down and run a deep post, a little play action in the back here, and watch as he's just going to come wide open. A little play action. Now look what he's got out here. Nobody down here in deep center field. He does a nice throw. I thought initially he might have underthrew it. Nobody's even catching it.
Rufus Brown was the closest guy, number 7, as you get another look at it. And once the world-class skier got it right there, it was all downhill.
Looked like Rufus Brown was expecting some help in the center of the field and didn't get it.
You know, Bloom is a big play type of guy. The first time he touched it ever last year, he went 75 yards on a punt return against Colorado State. The first time he ever touched it as a receiver was a 94-yard touchdown.
Yeah.
And he just took that one 81 yards in a hurry.
Hey, he said, this is nothing. Said, I don't have all those clothes on. It's not cold. It's not slippery. And it's level.
It was level. So 10-7, just like that. Everhart's kick will go to the 6. Took Alfonso Thorpe, and Thorpe got only to about the 24-yard line. And a little pushing and shoving at the end of the play. Well, earlier we asked you our Aflac trivia question. Which former Colorado Buffalo was the first man to lead the NFL in rushing in his first two seasons? Fellas, any guesses?
I haven't had time to think. Bienemy? It's
pretty quick. Swanee?
I'd go with the same guy, Bienemy, Eric.
I'd say Bobby Anderson. I have no idea. Really. Oh, we're going back. Whizzer White.
Oh,
yeah.
Look at this.
Well, you know, when you're a Chief Justice, you get some play on our air. Byron Whizzer White, gone on to bigger and better things, went on to bigger and better things other than football. Passed away not that long ago.
The Sigma Chi.
Is he?
Yeah.
Are we hitting your, speaking of that, are we hitting your house next week?
Well, yeah, we
at
could.
Purdue, old Purdue?
Yes, we could.
Okay. I know you've got a hall of shame there where you've once lived, so we probably should visit. We're just warning the guys up in West Lafayette for next week. Second down and 5. Wide open over the middle, and a first down to Willie Reed. Clyde Sorrell made the stop, but Willie Reed getting more work. Not much change on the scoreboard from last week. We all fanned on that one.
What is this, the fourth week? I think the guy that's making these things up, thinking them up, are going a little bit more difficult than we need.
Yeah, I think they're trying to embarrass us. And we can usually do that by ourselves.
Yeah.
Yeah. First down from the gun, slip screen over to P.K. Sand. And a nice open field hit puts him down before he can get going. Sorrell, again on that corner, is the guy that made the hit. And he said, oh, man, I hit my shoulder in the same time.
Yeah. Looks like he may just have a burner.
So Florida State's big lead evaporated on one long touchdown. They had an opportunity with a first and goal at the 1 yard line, had to settle for a field goal the last time they had it. Sorrell goes out, and a timeout taken by Colorado. That's their final one of the first half. 7-10 remaining in the second quarter. Seminoles at home leading by 3.
Her inspiration is a light, and it's burning bright. The taste of Dr. Pepper, the taste of originality, someone's individuality, and it's my personality.
Be you, the world you know.
Be you, nothing's better than Dr. Pepper.
Spicy garlic shrimp, fire grilled chicken, and our famous baby back ribs. Chili's Fajita Trio. Want more flavor?
The persistence of 135 years of experience. The performance that has enabled us to work with more than half the Fortune 500. Rely on the strength of Pacific Life.
Which of the nation's top 10 research universities is the fastest growing? Where are they pioneering medical advancements and revolutionizing healthcare?
Anything is possible here.
With 3 Nobel Prizes awarded in physics last year, this university received 2.
If you always question, if you always strive to be better than you are, you will achieve things you never thought possible.
I admire the Oakland Raiders for their sportsmanship. They wouldn't think of playing dirty. Just a bunch of guys out to enjoy a friendly game of football.
Jake's still getting used to the thin air in Denver.
Raiders, Broncos, Monday night on ABC.
Whoa.
ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Hummer. Check out the H2 at your local dealer. Hummer, like nothing else. Verizon Wireless, we never stop working for you. Allstate, you're in good hands with Allstate. And Gatorade Thirst Quencher. Gatorade, is it in you? Capital City of Florida, Tallahassee, Doak Campbell Stadium, and the hometown Noles leading, but by only 3 after the long touchdown by Gary Barnett's Buffaloes on the one pass play, Greenberg to Bloom, 81 yards, makes it 10-7. 7-10 remaining in the quarter. Chris Ricks now will work from the shotgun. Seminoles from their own 37 is going to flare it out of the backfield to Willie Reed. A lot of white jerseys around. Willie does what he can and got across the 41-yard line.
impressed with Chris Ricks today. He's very under control. Seems to be in the knowing what's going on, where he wants to go with the ball, and letting the game come to him, not pre-deciding where I'm going to throw the football, but waiting to see what the coverage does and see who's open and go there.
Those numbers are pretty darn good. And so Crew looking on the defensive coordinator for Colorado.
His defense in the first three games twice has given up over 35 points. And they're a lot better than that.
They come in 96th in the country in points allowed. They've only allowed Florida State 10 so far. Third down, a long five from the 42. Ricks with time. Zips it complete. First down. Nope, he dropped it. Dominic Robinson saying, wait a minute. And the official came running in, the side judge, and said it hit the turf.
Now that should have been a completion. The guy was wide open. Chris just threw the ball a little bit to his outside. Right here, just threw it. He should have thrown it right at him, stuck him with it. And he threw it a little bit high and outside, and he drops it.
I think we'll see a lot better from this angle. This will be a good look here. That's a good call. Tried to pin it on his thigh pad, and it hit the turf and then rolled over with it. But it's incomplete. Bloom will take a fair catch here. Jesse Stein's punt. Goes 45 yards, no return. And Colorado, trailing by only three, gets the ball back. Remember, they have no timeouts left, but still plenty of time in the first half. 6:27 remaining in the second quarter. Next Saturday at 3:30 Eastern, we got a great lineup of regional games highlighted by Pittsburgh, Texas A&M in the BCS Spotlight game presented by ADT. Wake Forest and Virginia in the ACC. We'll be at Old Purdue against the Fighting Irish. We'll have a Pac-10 game as well. Check your local listings for the game in your area or get ESPN game plan and watch the game of your choice. Crowd trying to come to life on this hot day for the Seminoles defense. And slipping and going down is Calhoun. And Brian Calhoun's had most of his 78 yards on two plays today, a 49-yarder and a 23-yarder.
And he was looking for that, too. There was nothing up the middle. The defense had stuffed it and looking to go around the side, and there was nothing there.
Sixth time there's been no gain or a loss on the play, and a running play for the Buffaloes, and so they find themselves in a long yardage situation again after dropping a couple. Second down and 12. Two tight ends set for Colorado. Greenberg will give it off to Calhoun again. And again, that tough defense for Florida State. Jerome Carter came up from the secondary, and he made the stop. We won't stop before we head to John Saunders in New York. John?
Brad, and Stephen Moore of Oregon won't stop as well, and that's being a problem for the Wolverines. They get a few hands on him, but no one tackles, and then he just takes off. Stephen Moore going 61 yards in this punt return as Oregon adds to the lead now, 21-6 over Michigan.
It's up at Alton Stadium.
Yeah,
you ever been there?
Place about half as big as the big house.
Oh, boy, that little bandbox place up there. Okay, they get you up there. They're gonna turn you loose.
Third and long. Greenberg completes it. Not going to be enough for the first down to Sapnuski, though. He got only about 5 of the 10 he needed. A.J. Nicholson, the linebacker who had a penalty earlier, makes a nice play there from his linebacker position.
Nicholson in there for Kendall Pope, who is out with an injury.
And it's punting time. John Torp, a sophomore punter, stands inside his own 5. And that's Chris Davis. And Chris has got some moves and some speed. He sets back at his own 40. Hit it way up in the air.
Good kick.
Beautiful kick. It's going to bounce out of bounds just inside the 40. In fact, right at the 40-yard line. So still good field position for Florida State. 47-yard kick with no return. But because he had to kick from near his own 5-yard line, Florida State's got their timeouts and 4:18 to work with. We take a look at our Pacific Life game summary in this one so far. Rafonso Thorpe on a perfect pass from Chris Ricks, capped an 80-yard march. Xavier Bedia with a field goal made it 10-0. And then Jeremy Bloom, 81 yards, about as fast as you can blink your eye, on a perfect throw from Greenberg. And that is where we stand. 10-7 Florida State with the Noles and the football back at their own 40-yard line. Ricks steps up in the pocket. Deep out to Thorpe. Thorpe's right there. Boy, that one covered a lot of territory. And a 24-yard pickup.
He's got an arm. He can throw it. He just steps up and throw it. You know, they love this. Quarterbacks, wide receivers, single coverage out here. Just going to go down and break to the outside. Single coverage.
He threw that from the left hash. That's a long throw.
Yeah, that's a long throw, but they love it. And they just, you know, it's that's what you like, pitch and catch with your wide receiver.
First down, Seminoles at the Buffalo's 36-yard line. Quick throw this time to P.K. Sam. Sam, nice couple of moves and a stiff arm, and he's inside the 20. Down to the 19-yard line. Florida State's got something working with 4 minutes left in the quarter. 17 yards on that play.
Boy, is that strange noise you hear on the sideline at the far ends of the line. That's the wide receivers licking their lips. Every time they come out and see man-to-man coverage, see a guy playing them off that deep, they're saying, okay, just give it to me any way you can.
Just get it out here.
At the 19, they continue with a no-huddle from the gun. Ricks flares this one out of Jones in the backfield. Greg puts a hand in there.
He is alone.
Did he drop the ball? Officials in Colorado say they got the ball.
He dropped the ball, Brad. I'm standing right by where he came out of the bounds. Jones came out of the bounds. He got hit. Stiff-armed the guy right in the head. He loves to do that. Stiff-armed him, lost the ball. But when it was recovered by Colorado, the ball had already gone out of bounds. There's a great stiff arm. He's going to lose the ball about right here. The ball pops out. Now watch the ball. It's going. It's out of bounds.
Oh, good call, Swanee. Thanks. You're right on top of it. So just that close. We talked to Greg yesterday about his running style and about those stiff arms that he throws. We'll talk about that after this play. Second down and 9. Play action. Ricks in trouble. Looking to throw on the run, and now he'll keep it. And again, he takes a lick and gets covered at about the 14-yard line. Swanee, you're the guy that asked Greg Jones, when he does throw those stiff arms, what he aims for.
Yeah, he's got such huge, powerful arms. We've seen him do it a number of times. And he says, I said, what do you aim for, their chest? He goes, no, I aim. I take the arm. Number 6 takes an arm. I give him right to him in the head. I said, I just attack those guys.
That's when I said he's a cousin of Joe Frazier. I said, is Joe Frazier teach you that one? Just go to the head. Smoking Greg.
He's a cousin.
Yep.
Yeah.
Third down at 6. And now Ricks will come under center. Did they run out of time? I didn't think they did.
Timeout was called by the wide receiver, Brad. He looked up at the clock. It was about to run down, and the wide receiver on the near side, as you're sitting up there, called the timeout.
Got down to 1 second, and I think Chris thought he could have gotten the playoff, but they take one to assure they're not going to end up with a third down and longer situation. There's the timeout called from the near side.
Probably he heard that from the bench. Some of the coaches from the bench were probably hollering.
Profonso called the timeout. Yeah. So Florida State's down to 1. 2:39 remaining in the half. They lead 10-7 and trying to add to that lead. Just 2 races to go. 5 drivers still have a chance at winning the IRL IndyCar Series. We'll see if anybody can get to the top and stay there. Don't miss the Toyota Indy 400 tomorrow at 3 Eastern, noon Pacific, right here on ABC Sports. Yeah, the Buffaloes have come from Boulder. Yep. They've only played one other ACC team in their history. That could have been our Aflac trivia question.
Mm-hmm.
That was in 1957. They played a bowl game against Clemson. Other than that, they don't come this way that often. And both these teams, we have to tip our caps for their non-conference schedules. You look at these 2 non-conference schedules of these clubs, and it makes your eyes roll.
Yeah, 2 of the best. 2 of the toughest non-conference schedules. And there's a look at Gary Barnett. You know, he had some injured players. He didn't come with his starting quarterback, his starting running back, his best defensive player. But he brought his team in there ready to play, and he's got them down 3 points just before halftime.
Florida State 4 wideouts for Chris Ricks on a third down and a short 6 at the Buffalo's 14-yard line. Ricks fires complete to P.K. Sam. I think he's about a foot short. The forward progress. He got lifted up and carried way back to about the 12-yard line. But where he caught the ball is nearer the 9. But I still think he's a football or two lengths shy of picking up the first down. And you wonder what Bobby Bodden will do right here. Yeah, there's no question. They bring out the field goal unit.
Guys, that was a good play that Florida State called, but I think when you go back and look at it and the coaches take a look at the film,
should've
they'll talk to
deeper,
the receiver,
right?
Yeah, tell them, make sure you get your depth.
He just came back too far.
Yeah, just a little bit, and he's coming back to the ball. He's got to stop before he crosses that mark.
Xavier Betia will stay warmed up and turn around away from his 26-yard field goal that's upcoming. You know, I think with Bobby, this is a couple of things here. This is only 2 feet to go, and in some circumstances, he might say, dadgummit, let's go for it. But I think he wants to give his kicker a little bit of confidence because there's going to be a lot bigger games. Not that this isn't a big one. There'll be bigger games down the line, and I think everybody knows that he missed one against Miami last year that could have beaten the undefeated Hurricanes. This is a 26-yard attempt from the right hash. He hit a 20-yarder earlier. And the kick is up, and it's good. So add 3 for the Noles with 2:13 remaining in the half. And you see the smile. That'll help your confidence a little bit.
Good point. You know, this is it's a long season. This is a long game, and you want to get some points on the board. You don't want to walk away from there without any points just before halftime. And at the same time, it's a chip shot for your field goal kicker. How often do you ask him to make a long one?
Right.
Now just go out there and make a chip shot.
We talked about Florida State and Colorado and who they play. Florida State seems like they've always played tough schedules, even when they were an independent and everybody wanted to play them, and then they got good. But
And they'd say, we'd go anywhere and play anybody at any time. But look at this schedule.
They still do.
Colorado played in the championship game of the Big 12 last year. Miami was in the national championship game. Notre Dame was, 10-3, had a great year. And Florida, they're always good. Overall rank is 27th in the nation.
Add that to their ACC schedule, and the ACC's gotten better. And speaking of tough schedules, Colorado State, they just survived that one. That's become a bloodbath in the last 5 years or so. UCLA, Washington State, they split those two. And Florida State, their overall schedule right now is ranked 10th in the country. So neither of these teams is ducking anybody, that's for sure.
There are no Division I AA schools on directional
southeast, northeast.
No directional schools on there.
We know what direction Jeremy Bloom would like to take this kick return if he gets his mitts on it, and he does from about the 13. But this time they've got him all wrapped up. The other kick returner back there with him, I think, came over and it caused some hesitation.
Yeah, they were talking about it. Said, Jeremy, you want this one or not?
He's been the guy that scored the touchdown as a pass receiver. Gary Barnett now will not have any timeouts, Bob. I don't know what that does with 2:07, but they got decent field position.
And in college, you know, first downs are a timeout. You know, they stop the clock for first downs, and his quarterback has done well. He's not turned the ball over. He's 8 of 10 for 137 yards, and he's, I'd take a look at it. Up here, he's got single coverage at the top of the screen.
Comes to the near side and completes it to Hackett. Nope. Incomplete. That one hit the turf, too. Now, wait a minute. Maybe they are giving it to him. Yes, they are. At the 34. Take it back. Crowd booing. They thought that he trapped the ball. As it is, it's 2nd down and 3.
Yeah. Greenberg is in charge out there.
Eric throws over the middle, completes this one. Oh, you talk about getting planted. Nice tackle. Michael Boulware with a form job on the receiver. And it's going to be 3rd down and about a yard. You see the clock running. It would stop if they get a 1st down here. To the ground game they go, and they've got a 1st down. And a fumble. Knocked away from behind, and Florida State's got it.
That was a good play by the defender.
Is the guy that took a swipe at the ball and got it. The Noles have it back with 1:11 to go in the half. That was a first down run.
Well, I couldn't see who got it, but one of the defenders came upfield and went back.
Take another look. There's the hit from behind. That might be Emmanuel.
Is that Emmanuel, 90?
Kind of hard to see. It's 95. It's Wembley, and he's had a good half. Yeah. Wembley's the guy that caused the fumble.
That's a good play coming back. I mean, you can't practice those things. I mean, how often are you going to come back in that situation? That's just good coaching.
Let's see if Florida State can take advantage. Ricks getting some pressure. I don't know how he got out of that one, and he hit his man, but he dropped it. Dominique Robinson. Would have been a big, big play on a broken play.
Ricks did a great job of avoiding all the danger back there in the backfield and getting the ball downfield. And Dominic just drops it.
You know, Chris had that one bad throw where that slipped off his hand trying to get one in the end zone. Other than that, he's had two or three drops today. His numbers already good would be even better. He's 16 out of 21 and could easily have been 18 or 19 out of 21.
And his coaches have to be very pleased with the fact that when he does scramble like this, boys, he's still looking downfield to throw the ball, making real smart decisions.
Good point. Second and 10 at the 42. Wants to throw a screen to Jones. Jones with blockers in front. But that hole closed in a hurry. Picked up about five. It'll be third and five. We're under a minute in the half. Florida State with one timeout remaining.
This Colorado defense, Brad, is a nice combination of big guys up front and speed behind them.
So Florida State needs five as we're winding down to a half minute here. They need the first down before they can think about a touchdown or anything else. And they're wasting some time here. They're telling Chris Ricks, get the ball snapped. Flares it out to Jones. One-on-one out there, and he's tripped up. Nice open field stop, and I can see why they have Clyde Sorrell back in there as a starter. And remember, he had the bad shoulder earlier, and he makes a nice open field tackle.
I think Florida State is missing the two backs that they don't have in there, Lorenzo Booker and Leon Washington, the two guys that can make guys miss. Greg Jones has been out there and has been stopped by one-on-one tackles a couple of times. Those other guys might make a miss.
We're about 15 seconds away from halftime. Talking about Lorenzo Booker. He's missed a couple games now with a sprained MCL, and it happened on this particular play. It was against Maryland and went down and clutched his knee. He had 88 yards and a couple of touchdowns on the season. Gets up limping, and they're going to hope to get him back maybe by next game.
He's a redshirt freshman who came out of California, and he wasn't the player of the year. He was pretty close to it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, his final decision came down between Notre Dame and Florida State. He said he had to go where his heart is, so he came to Florida State. I talked with him just this morning before the game began. He said he's never been hurt before, never had to sit out, and said it's hard for him to do. He's anxious. He wants to get in the play. But he said, we've got a great back in Greg Jones. I know if I just take my time and heal up, when I come back, I'll be ready to play.
Yeah, he was averaging over 7 yards a carry before he was hurt. Florida State converted on a 4th-and-3 earlier. They've got 4th-and-3 here. They'll go for it in the waning moments of the second quarter. Chris Ricks on the run, now sets and fires. Got a man open. Quick runs up Thorpe at the 10. And Thorpe goes down. It's first down, Florida State. 4 seconds left in the half.
Clock stops until they move the chains.
And they have one timeout to use. They can just spike it here and bring out their field goal unit. First and goal at the 10. Chris Ricks up under center. There's the spike. The clock stops. Should be 1 second left.
So that's
it shows double zero on the scoreboard.
Well, that's not a home team clock guy, is it?
Not at all. Yeah, now it's back to 2:28, and it isn't that either.
Yeah.
There's 1 second, possibly two left.
If you've got a timeout, you take it. You got a timeout, you got to take it. I mean, why not take it?
Exactly. So this will be a 27-yard field goal attempt. John and Terry and Craig will be at Times Square Stadium in New York for the Valvoline Halftime Show after this kick. Xavier Beitia, 27-yarder, got it. So the fumble recovery for Florida State turns into 3 points for them as the halftime comes to a close. Let's go down to Lynn Swan.
Well, Coach, you came into the ball game making no excuses about injuries. Your guys have played tough. With the exception of a couple of plays, you'd be up in this ball game. What's a message you delivered to this football team at halftime?
Well, it's going to be the same I delivered before the game started. I said, you give them, after the first 20 minutes of this game, everything evens out. And they're just guys like our guys are. Now it comes down to who's playing best and who's going to make plays. And that's just what it's going to come down to here the rest of this game.
Quick assessment of your quarterback, how he's playing in the ball
game. Well, I think he's playing well. You know, he's made a couple really good throws and a good adjustments. And so I'm really proud of all those guys.
Thanks, Coach. Brad?
All right, so Colorado, one touchdown strike on an 81-yard pass, but it's Florida State at intermission at home, leading 16-7. John Terry and Pony will be at Times Square Stadium for a Valvoline halftime show after this.
By out-accelerating, out-handling, and outperforming the competition, the Grand Prix Comp G earned Pontiac the right to become the official performance machines of the NCAA. The newly redesigned 2004 Pontiac Grand Prix. Fuel for the soul.
In 1969, the legend of Gatorade embarked on an historic journey from the swamp of Gainesville to the battle-hardened turf of the NFL. The baby back ribs weren't the only thing getting basted in the heat of Kansas City.
E.J. Hollop, the toughest guy on the team, kept running out of gas.
It was hotter than a Texas tamale.
Salvation came in the ring of a phone.
Ray Graves called me. He was a good friend.
Ray Graves of the Florida Gators said his players were drinking this stuff called Gatorade.
That Gatorade really did the job. It was like liquid gold.
Come on, Lenny.
Against the heavily favored Vikings in Super Bowl IV, the Chiefs emerged victorious. And the rest is history.
There's no better way to rehydrate athletes.
And today, Gatorade is on every sideline, every down, every game.
From boys to men, from one generation to the next, the games never end. And the legend continues.
Star premium quality denim. Wrangler. Real comfortable jeans.
The Valvoline Halftime Show. Brought to you by Valvoline's Max Life, who reminds you at 75,000 miles, it's time to switch to Max Life. From Times Square, New York, John Saunders and Terry Bowden.
Welcome back to the Valvoline Halftime Show as once again we take a look at our new running back, Craig James. The Pony joins us. John Saunders, Terry Bowden, and Craig James. We've had our coach here for a while. Now we've got a running back. Welcome.
Well, it's good to be here. You know what? I'm here. Really, I feel like I'm representing all these Auburn fans. They sent me these emails for things, possible thoughts I might have for you. I don't understand.
Well, yeah, I'm telling you. Back then, I can imagine. Of course, with Dickerson, I don't think much happened for you. Not much good, I would imagine.
It's good to show that I actually did get to play when he was there.
Yeah, once in a while. We're going to hear more from these guys in a moment. Actually, a very pointed discussion. In fact, Terry Bowden was back in the news this week over some comments he made off the record a couple of years ago. Comments that raise many more questions than they answer. Here's John Berman of ABC News.
L over motion. 46.
In Terry Bowden's first season at Auburn, the Tigers went 11-0. A perfect record. But was it a clean one? In a two-year-old interview published this week, Bowden says when he arrived at Auburn, boosters were paying players as much as $15,000, a scheme he tried to stop. Bowden, an ABC sports analyst, says that interview was off the record and won't or can't say anything now about the Auburn program.
In your first year there, were players getting money from fans?
There are certain things I cannot talk about at Auburn because of the settlement that I signed with Auburn. There are certain things that I cannot talk about.
The university called the interview old news. Auburn also said Bowden signed documents while he was coached there, certifying that Auburn was clean.
if Auburn had been in violation of NCAA policy while you were coach there, would you have been lying by signing these documents?
Yes, I would have. I'd have been lying.
Did you lie while you were coach at Auburn?
I would say there's certain things that I'm under contract legal agreement not to talk about.
Again, Bowden has said that he straightened out the program. The NCAA will not say whether it has or will investigate Auburn again. The problem of overzealous boosters seems pervasive in big-time college sports. Chris Weber is still dealing with payments he received at Michigan, and someone gave Maurice Claret that Carta drive that got him in so much trouble.
It's about bragging rights. It's for that booster to be able to sit at the cocktail party with his buddies and say, you see that kid? I'm the reason that kid is going to XYZ University.
Fans who will do anything to win. The question is, are colleges and the NCAA doing enough to stop them? John Berman, ABC News, New York.
Terry, it's very clear as you watch that interview, you're put in a very uncomfortable situation because of that agreement you have at Auburn.
Yeah, it was a very difficult interview because I was limited about what I could say.
Well, let me say this, you know, the thing about the interview, 15 grand wouldn't have gotten many good players for my year. I know that part about it. But, you know, you can't control these boosters. These guys are out there, and they're out, if they're at a party or a function with a player, and they come up and shake your hand and they give you some money, you can't control that. There's no way a coach can say, hey, watch everything that you're doing out there.
Greg, you can control the boosters. You look at that booster, you look at your boosters and tell your boosters, sir, if you do anything to my players, you give them anything, not only will I kick you out of the office, you'll never come around the office, you'll never talk to my players. You've got to tell the boosters that.
That sounds practical, but reality is this. We've got to get to a zero-tolerance place where the coach knows, the player knows, if I give you money or if I take money, then I'm never going to coach again in the college athletic world, and I'm not going to play any longer in that world. If that comes to that zero-tolerance policy, we've got a chance.
Greg, now listen, I do think that most coaches feel that if they do something wrong and they get NCAA violations on a school, they're going to lose their job, and they're probably not going to coach again. I think it comes down to the morals of the coach. Am I going to do this? Am I going to make this move and cheat to win? Am I going to set this example for my players? Because face it, if you're a football coach and the first thing you teach a kid to do is cheat, I mean, what else
it's
can terrible. You teach him? What
it's
else
terrible.
Can you teach
terrible,
a player as a football coach?
As a coach, and you're sitting here because of it, you had a standard, and you were living to that standard, and that standard got you a seat right here because those boosters
right.
control with their money going into those universities what they want to have happen and what not happen.
Well, I just think you have to do it. I think you have to go to the boosters and tell them that they can't do this and it's your responsibility. I don't care what your profession is. There's a right thing and a wrong thing to do, and believe me, not every program, not every coach is doing it.
That's right. It's not as bad as it used to be.
But it is still going on today, and we've seen the case in point. What's happening at Baylor, what's going on all around the country. It's going to be a problem that's going to have to be dealt with for years to come. This is the Valvoline Halftime Show. We'll continue with more from Times Square in a moment.
What do you think? It's perfect. That's exactly what I want.
What?
Except bigger.
What do you mean bigger?
Something really pops the eye. Maybe rubies alternating with the sapphires. More stones. Pave diamonds all the way around.
Life's little expenses. Another good reason to keep your car around. That's why at 75,000 miles, switch to Valvoline's Max Life. Its added ingredients help prevent wear on critical parts.
Hey, this is nothing, guys. For the honeymoon?
Oh. At 75,000, time to switch to Max Life.
This is no game. This is a battle. I train every day with just one thing in mind. And that's kicking somebody's. I'm faster, stronger, more explosive than I've ever been in my life. My edge is Bowflex.
Call for a free video or DVD or visit us online at BowflexEndZone.com.
You think it's easy banging heads with guys half my age? It is.
The universities of the Atlantic Coast Conference share a proud tradition, one of honor and integrity, of camaraderie and sportsmanship, of high academic standards and intellectual scholarship, of classic athletic competition, and of vision and courage. Throughout the years and decades, that tradition has continued unbroken. The Atlantic Coast Conference, a tradition of excellence, then, now, and always.
When the Navy sought a power source for a new generation of ship, we had the right energy. When the nation called for better hurricane forecasting, conditions here were perfect. And when a life-saving cancer drug was in short supply, we had the right chemistry. How fast do ideas move? At the speed of imagination. Florida State University. Ideas that move.
And welcome back once again to Times Square Stadium. John Saunders, Terry Bowden, and Craig James. As we run down the day's scores and highlights, you have to go all the way back to 1986, the last time UCLA played a number one team, and that was Oklahoma. And they also lost that game. Today, facing Oklahoma again, and they looked very good early on, but they couldn't stop the special teams. Antonio Perkins takes this one and goes 85 yards for a touchdown, and this was his second of the day.
Great teams find ways to win, and they do it with their special teams at their offense deep to work. They've got great athletes. They have enough to put them on their defense and find a way, on their special teams, and find a way to win.
And I felt like, you know, the fact that Stoops made such a big issue of punt protection this week, he sent the message out to his troops, fellas, we got to improve in the special teams area, and they've done it.
And anybody who questioned whether or not Oklahoma has a quarterback, question answered, right?
Hey, amen. And how about Mark Clayton, wide receiver? They got three out there that can play. This team is fully loaded.
I'm just thinking their running attack is going to be a little better, too. When you got a good quarterback like that throwing, now they'll bring along their running attack. It'll get better as the season progresses.
And defense can bail you out any time. Michigan against Oregon, the Wolverines, for whatever, they were seeing stars as they were watching this game. And the star of the day was Stephen Moore, who fields this punt, and again, we're watching punt return for a touchdown, 61 yards. Michigan didn't show up in this game. 56 seconds they had the ball in the first quarter.
Two speeds in this game, fast by Michigan and smoking by Oregon. And Michigan can't catch up to them.
And they were reading our press clippings, my talking about them so good, they're the best team in the country. They've been reading their press clippings. They were set for an upset here because Oregon is much too good of a team to go in there not ready to play.
If they lose the game, it'll be the third time since 2000 they've gone to the Pac-10 to play and come up empty with a high ranking. Georgia against LSU. Matt Mock picked off by Sean Jones, and that stalls a drive. Chiron Carey goes 21 yards. Look at him duck and weave and get to the end zone. 7-3. But the story of the day, Billy Bennett does have the 3 points for Georgia, but he's missed three field goals as well.
And you got to have field goals. These are two great defenses. When you have great defenses on the field, it's going to come down to your field goal kicker, and he's not making it happen.
And you know, David Green is the leader of that ball club. On the road, he's got to come up better than 8-22. He started getting hot, though, lately, so we'll see if he can do it in the second half.
Georgia under Mark Richt, perfect 9-0 on the road. But they're taking it on the chin right now. Washington, they won 31 straight against Idaho, looking to make it 32. And the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame against Michigan State, again, only field goals. This offense has not found a way to get going.
And it takes the fighting out of the Irish. There's no Fighting Irish about them right now. This is a football team that has no identity out there. They had a good year last year under Willingham. He's a good coach. But they've got to find a way to get back out and be physical like the Irish used to be.
They got to find that West Coast playbook. That's what they got to do. I think they get three wideouts, four wideouts. I think you have to give the quarterback a better option, more receivers, protection, and two receiver routes. I just don't think that gets it. I think you can give him more chances to throw to different people.
Florida State with the lead over Colorado. That's the game you're watching right now. Your dad starts out with three wins in the ACC. If he wins this one, he believes he's back. Everyone else is going to believe as well.
And he believes Chris Ricks is back, too, because he used the no-huddle shotgun offense. That puts all the weight on your quarterback, and they're making a lot of yardage, but they're not putting the ball in the end zone enough.
But Colorado's doing a pretty respectable job over 200 yards offense. That surprised me.
A couple of strikes down the middle as well. We'll continue. This is the Valvoline Halftime Show from New York.
Hey, you okay?
Life's little expenses, another good reason to keep your car around. That's why at 75,000 miles, switch to Valvoline's MaxLife. Its added ingredients help prevent wear on critical parts.
Hello, gorgeous girl.
At 75,000, time to switch to MaxLife.
There's a fine line between pleasure and pain. Your muscles will let you know when you've crossed it. Introducing new 8-Hour from Tylenol with two layers. One that's fast, one that lasts. All day, one dose. New 8-Hour from Tylenol. Because when you push your muscles this hard, you're gonna need pain relief that lasts this long. Eight-Hour, it's the new Tylenol for muscle pain.
The Valvoline Halftime Show, brought to you by Valvoline's MaxLife, who reminds you at 75,000 miles, it's time to switch to MaxLife.
Comedy rules on ABC Tuesday when shocking secrets are revealed in two season premieres. First, Jim is exposed.
He's pretending to be a moron to cover up being a jackass.
And on Less Than Perfect, Claude unveils the biggest decision of her career.
It's so awful and wonderful and hard.
It all starts 9, 8 Central, ABC Tuesday.
Next Saturday at 3:30 Eastern Time here on ABC, some of you will see the Fighting Irish from Notre Dame take on the Boilermakers of Purdue. Others get Pitt facing Texas A&M. Some will be in the ACC to watch Wake Forest face Virginia or a Pac-10 game. Check local listings for the game available in your area. Time now for our No Huddle Highlights. We begin in the SEC with Tennessee and Florida. Smokey was ready, and the rest of the Volunteers were as well. This is the end of the first half. Casey Clawson, 48 yards, the Hail Mary to James Banks.
They're going to question Coach Ron Zook because he could have run the clock out when he was on offense.
Yeah, but look at all the blue jerseys around the football. They're looking at the ball. Find a white shirt and cover it up.
Tennessee wins it 24-10 in the Swamp. A near upset at Ohio State. Defending national champions facing Bowling Green. Craig Krenzel out with an injury. Scott McMullen is in. And Lydell Ross, they finally found their running game.
Well, that's exactly right. That's the one thing they have to have at Ohio State to be good is run the football, because they don't throw it very much. They had over 200 yards of running.
Just the same, Bowling Green was still in the game late. Josh Harris gets picked off by Will Allen.
It's Will Allen again making another great play at the end of a game. Chris Gamble in the secondary, two superstar All-Americans, gives that front eight the ability to mix things up, and that's why the defense just keeps winning games for Ohio State.
Once again, and Marshall against Kansas State, Darren Sproles, you see the score at the top. Kansas State is trailing, but Sproles goes 12 yards for the touchdown. K-State has the lead at 20-19, but Marshall backup quarterback Graham Gopner comes back and goes 2 yards to Jason Rader. The two-point conversion is good, and Kansas State now down to the final seconds. Jeff Schwinn, incomplete as it's knocked down by Marshall. And the Thundering Herd pull off the upset. And again, people are going to point to Bill Snyder, head coach of Kansas State. He plays that soft schedule. Cal, Troy, McNeese, UMass, and then loses to Marshall. They don't seem to be mentally tough.
Now you got to play better people because you don't get tested. You had a lot of blowouts. You get into a tight ball game, and then you're not ready to play at the end of the game.
I tell you what he's missing right now is L. Roberson, yeah, the quarterback. They're off right now. They got 1 week off. Then they go to Austin to play the Longhorns. He needs to get Roberson on the field.
Big news in this one is we found out Tennessee looked good today against Florida. Now you see Marshall win against Kansas State. How good is Tennessee?
Hey, 2 weeks ago, Tennessee beats Marshall 34-24, and everybody says, oh, that was a soft run on the schedule. Now it looks like a pretty darn impressive win.
Yes, Stan Hill, their star quarterback, was playing in that game.
Without question, Marshall always tough. Mid-American Conference has done a great job thus far this year, and Kansas State now, they go into the Big 12 schedule with a loss. Right now, let's take you back out to your games. We'll have scores and highlights throughout.
Florida State's had two Heisman Trophy winners, Chris Wenke of the Carolina Panthers, and that's Charlie Ward of the New York Knicks. Charlie, part of the 93 National Championship team. They're being honored here at Doak Campbell Stadium as well at halftime. And at halftime, Florida State at home leading 16-7. Our presentation of college football will continue after this message and a word from our ABC stations. You're watching ABC Sports Championship Television.
Hey, hon, how are you? We're good. You know us, up at the crack of dawn, right on schedule, no fooling around. In fact, gotta go, real busy here, and Dip says hi.
You kind of have to know.
I feel like I kind of do.
Picture mail that talks from Sprint. Now at Sprint stores, get great deals on a wide selection of PCS Vision picture phones starting at $99.99. Share it when it happens.
Hey! That thing got a Hemi, right? But I got something you don't got. Check this out.
Dodge Ram 1500. The Hemi legend continues. Hit it! Grab Dodge's 770 powertrain limited warranty. Ford, Chevy, and Toyota don't match it.
Next week, it's the premiere of Wild Wednesday.
Yeah.
Starting with the one-hour granddaddy of all premieres.
She's pregnant.
The wildest my wife and kids yet.
I have 9 months to take dummy to daddy.
Then, the night gets even wilder. 25 women try to attain the best bachelor yet in the two-hour premiere. It all starts at 8, 7 Central, ABC Wild Wednesday.
September is your last chance. Time for one last cookout. One last road trip.
And in September, one last chance to grab a great selection of 2003 Dodges in stock with our best deals. Like the V8-powered 2003 Durango with a cash allowance of $4,500 or 0% APR financing for 60 months. Plus, get Dodge's fully transferable 7-year or 70,000-mile powertrain limited warranty. Great products, great protection, great deals. See your local Dodge dealer for the best values in America.
Our wireless network works here?
Yes.
Here?
Yes.
Here?
No.
No.
Yes.
Karen, you're the customer. Surely this is enough network for you, yes?
No.
Do we think alike or what? You want wireless coverage wherever you go. So at Alltel, we're expanding our digital network by over 150,000 square miles. Right now, you can connect the whole family with up to 5 phones for just 99 cents each. And unlimited night and weekend minutes. See store for details. Better digital coverage?
You got that right.
Alltel.
Herman and Sherman Smith lost 100 pounds each with the help of Subway low-fat sandwiches and exercise.
For 7 months, we ate nothing but Subway.
7 tasty sandwiches under 6 grams of fat, like the turkey breast with honey mustard sauce on fresh baked bread.
Everybody thinks we look better.
Subway, eat fresh.
Subway is proud to be the presenting sponsor of the Leon County 2003 Heart Walk. Subway would like to invite you to walk with Jared on Saturday, September 27th at 8 a.m. at Southwood. So come out and help fight heart disease with Jared and Subway restaurants. Subway.